In this figure, we're going to look at the endocrine and neural control of gastric secretion. In other words, how are the cells that line the wall of the stomach controlled, and how do their secretions aid digestion within the stomach? Now, let's give ourselves a little bit of orientation here first. In the upper right, we have a miniature version of the stomach here, right? Esophagus leading us into the stomach, small intestine on our way out, right? Stomach in between. If we look at the lining of that stomach, we take a very small spot here and we blow it up, we would see that that stomach lining has little pockets in it. These are called gastric glands, and they are lined with the cells that generate many of the secretions that are going to help control the digestion and as well as aid that digestion in the stomach lumen. And so the lumen would be this space right here, the space inside where the digestion occurs. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take a few of these cells right here and blow them up so we can examine what cell types are there, how they're controlled, and what they're producing. Okay, so first of all, the key secretions that are going to aid digestion in the stomach are going to be the production of acid, free protons, by parietal cells, as well as a proenzyme called pepsinogen from the chief cells. This proenzyme is actually a pro-protease. It's going to be converted into the protease pepsin, and proteases are enzymes that help with the digestion of proteins. Okay, so that's going to be our key function, is that acid secretion and this pepsin secretion aiding our digestion here. Now, how do we control it? Well, we can see that some of the stimulatory input are peptides and amino acids, right, leading us to the aiding the digestion of proteins through pepsin, but also distension of the wall of the GI tract. And that's going to be a stimulus to another cell type known as the G cell. The G cells are gastrin secreting hormones. This is a hormone. So you'll notice this secretion is moving into the interstitium, not into the lumen out here where the food is. It's moving into the interstitium where it can gain access to this schematic capillary we have here. And then it can go everywhere, right? It can gain access to many tissues in the body. And we'll see that some of its target tissues are actually right next to the G cells in anywhere in the stomach lining here, right? That's going to be stimulatory to the chief cells and their production of pepsinogen. It's going to be stimulatory to the parietal cells and the production of acid. And so now we have our stimulus and response linked, and we're already increasing our digestion in the stomach lumen. But in addition, that gastrin is going to stimulate another cell type called an enterochromaffin-like cell. And this is a cell that releases histamine. You've probably heard of histamine before. And in this case, it's acting in a paracrine fashion, meaning not through the bloodstream, but adjacent through the interstitium to adjacent cells, and is highly stimulatory to those parietal cells. This is actually the primary stimulus for this parietal cell acid secretion. It's actually indirect action of gastrin. So we're going to get significant acidification once we have this activation of this particular cell type. This actually leads us to an understanding of why many antacid drugs help by opposing the production of gastric histamine production. Okay, now next to our G cell, we have a D cell. D cells produce another paracrine agent called somatostatin. This guy acts as putting the brakes on the G cell, so it's decreasing the production of gastrin. Well, the D cells are tonically active. These are the cells that are turning off the G cells, which would then turn off the chief cells and parietal cells, keeping our stomach activity low between meals. You'll notice that they get inhibited once we eat a meal. But these are helping us to inhibit, right, either indirectly through inhibiting gastrin, or you can see they actually inhibit the parietal cell acid secretion directly. That's helping us keep that stomach activity minimized in between meals. Now, let's look at our neural input here. We also have vagus input. And the vagus nerve carries about 70-75% of our parasympathetic output, that autonomic output that's going to help control GI function. And you can see it, we're going to get innervation often through interneurons here of the enteric nervous system. But regardless, we're going to get input of the vagus nerve in response to things like distension of the stomach and other stimuli, or even cognitive ones such as thinking or smelling food, in which case this vagus nerve become active, and you can see we're going to get activation of the chief cells, activation of the parietal cells, activation of the G cells. You'll note inactivation of the D cells, turning off its inhibition and helping activation of all these secretions. They're going to help promote digestion.